students, today I am going to teach you computer class 6, chapter 3, video 2. The name of the chapter is word processor and tabular presentation. Inserting columns and rows in a table. While creating and making entry in a table, you might need to add columns and rows in between. Word provides the facility to add new columns to the right or left of any existing column and insert rows above or below the selected row. To add a new column, select the column by clicking on its top border adjacent to which you want to insert a new column. The Table Tool tab appears on the ribbon. Click on the Layout tab under it. Select either the left, insert left, or insert right button in the Rows and Columns group. An empty column gets inserted in the table as per the chosen option. Similarly, click either on the Insert Above or Insert Below buttons in the Rows and Columns group on the Layout tab to insert a new row. Let's see how to do this all. Suppose this is a table. So click here, it is selected. Click on Layout here, then select Insert Right. A column is inserted at the right hand side. If you will click Insert Left, a column will be inserted at the left hand side. In the same way, suppose you want to insert a row below, then click Insert Row Below from here. And if you want above, then click Insert Above. Like this, you can add a column and rows to your table. You can select as many as columns or rows as you want to add in a table, then right click on the selection, click on the insert option, choose the desired option from the cascading menu. Means you can click here, right click, insert, then column to the left, column to the right, insert row above, or insert row below. From here you can insert. Suppose you want to insert a row above, click here. And a row is inserted over here. Deleting rows and columns. Select the rows or columns. Click on the Layout tab under the Table Tools tab. Select the Delete option in the Rows and Columns group. A list of options appears. Choose the Delete Row or Delete Column option in the drop-down menu or right-click on the selected row or column that you wish to delete. Select the Delete Row or Delete Column option from the shortcut menu. Let's see how to do this. Click here. Layout. Delete. So, delete row. So, the row would be deleted. Again, delete row. Row is deleted. If you want to delete a column, suppose this column, then click here on delete and delete column. Again, delete column. So, this is the way how to delete columns and rows in your table. Formatting a table. Format the entire table by applying various style changes, row heights, column width, splitting, merging, or applying border and shading. A table can be formatted by using Table Styles Gallery. Table Styles is an inbuilt facility to change the appearance, color, and borders of a table. Click on the table that you want to format. Under Table Tools, click on Design tab. Select the desired style from the Table Styles group. So, how to format? Click on design. So, any of the design you can pick like this. So, there are many like this. So, you can format your table. Changing row height. There are different ways to alter the row height in a table. Select the row whose height is to be changed. Right click on the selected row. Select Table Properties option from the shortcut menu. The Table Properties dialog box will appear. Click on the Row tab. Select the Specify Height checkbox. Specify the height either by typing or by clicking the spin arrows. Choose one of the options from the row height in list box and click on OK. Let's see how to do this. Suppose this one. Click on layout, then height, increase height from here. So you can see I have increased the height of the row. Suppose here, if I want to increase the width, I can increase the width from here also. So this is the way how to increase the row height and width. Changing column width, you can resize the column width either by using the option available on the layout tab or by using mouse pointer. Select the column whose width you want to change. Click the layout tab. Select the properties button in the table group. The table properties dialog box will appear. Click on the column tab. Select the preferred width checkbox. Now increase or decrease the column width either by using the spin arrows or type the specific values to set the width and click on OK. So suppose this, right click, then table properties and column. I want to change its width, so I will decrease the width from here. Now you can see the width has been changed, or you can do from here also. Like this and like this. Splitting a cell means dividing the cell into separate cells. To split a cell, follow the given steps. Select the cell that you want to split. Click the layout tab. Select the split cells button in the merge group. The split cells dialog box appears. Define the number of rows and columns in the respective spin boxes into which you wish to split the selected cell and click on OK. So suppose I want to split this. So split cell. How many columns I want? Suppose I want two columns and one row. So I would split this. Now you can see it is splitted into two parts. Suppose I want to split this, then I have to click on layout, then split cell into how many columns I want. Suppose three columns and one row, then it is splitted into three parts. So this is the way how to split your cell. Merging cells. Merging means combining. Sometimes data is split into numerous segments of a cell and you want to combine it in a single cell to give it a better look. Merging the cells provides a way to consolidate data in one cell. Select the cell you want to merge. Click on the layout tab. Select merge cells button in the merge group and data gets merged into single cell. Suppose I want to merge this. So I will click merge cells. So all this is merged into a single cell. If I want to merge this, I will click on merge cell. So it is combined now, a single cell. So this is the way how we merge the cells. Applying borders and shading. You can enhance the appearance of table by applying variety of borders and shading styles. To add borders and shading, follow the given steps. Select the entire table by clicking on the table move handle. Click the design tab. Change the line style, line width by clicking line style, line width option respectively from the draw borders group. Click on the draw borders dialog box launcher or click on the drop down arrow next to the draw border button and select the border and shading option from the list. Let's do this. Design tab, then shading. I want this borders, want all borders, all borders. So like this I can change the shading. I can change the borders also, all borders. Even the color also, if I want the color, I have to select this and I have to give the pen color. So I can change the color of the table also. Whatever I want, I can do the formatting. So like this, I can do the changes in my table. You can apply borders, designs, and you can merge, you can split cells, you can add columns, you can add rows. Now rest of the chapter I will cover in my next video. Till then, take care, goodbye.